caught up in my feelings, I fuck around and kill another nigga. You ain't even gotta push me how I'm feeling now. I've been having mood swings like a Gemini. I could use the murder for therapy. I could make the news with it. Break the internet, have them all nervous and scared of me. Then get away sneaky clean, never seen a thing. I got.
Well, hello, Frostborn. It's great that we have a season 7 out. A lot of good things and things that maybe we don't like, but that's with every season, you know. In this video, I will be showing free-to-play players, lower-level ones, how to run these maps, how to run the underground. So we're going to start off with me going to Red Rock. Red Rock and Red Forest both are the harder versions of the underground. Basically, my setup is all free-to-play. Every free-to-play player is going to have bolas. They're going to have a stun trap or two, at least one potion, I'm sure, and food. Maybe not as many bandages, so I went with less bandages. I tried to make this as hard on myself as I could. When you run the underground, you need to ask yourself a simple question, and that is,
how tough are you?
How tough am I? How tough am I? I had a bowl of nails for breakfast this morning.
Yeah, so?
Without any milk.
Right this way. Sorry to keep you waiting.
Now, if you're as tough as that guy is, I'm sure this season will be easy for you. Asking yourself how tough you are will help you decide what kind of gear you want to take, what kind of gear you want to risk in the underground. I suggest for players who don't feel like they can eat a bowl of nails for breakfast without any milk to consider some of the advice I give in this video in order for you to raise your classes up and just make the most out of this season. Now, so far this season, I've already acquired a massive and a half of green and blue gear, a majority of it being armor, some weapons, but quite a bit, you know, that's a lot of points. It's gonna be very helpful for you lower class players, and any free-to-play player, they're gonna love that. So as long as you're grinding, you're able to get them points and you're able to raise yourself up. That only took me about three and a half hours to get a massive and a half. Now I did have a couple matches with opponents in maps. It doesn't seem like very many people are friendly, which is to be expected. It's Frostborn. Now luckily I was able to win most of those PvPs, at least the ones where my opponents didn't have gear that was twice as good as mine. But for those of you who are afraid to PvP, now's the time. Now is the time to practice. Take as little gear as you can. Like I said, you gotta find out how tough you are and try and win those little PvPs against other nakeds and gain that experience. Now, I am very unsure whether or not we should be attacking these giants. I mean, if you have to open a box, then you have to kill it. But there are situations where you don't have to fight the giants. Personally, I have not had much luck getting any gear out of giants. So it's not really worth attacking them for me. They hit a little too hard wearing cloth. So they don't seem as valuable as some of the regular mobs. As you've seen, I ran out of the giant's range. They do have a range. Some monsters do. The monsters that I've noticed that don't have a range are the ones you activate whenever you go to open a chest. They'll chase you all over the place, which you'll see here in 2 minutes. It's actually pretty wild how hard these mobs chase me, and I barely get away with my life. But I'm able to survive just by drawing out time. Here's where I found out the hard way that these mobs just keep chasing you even if you do your Thrasher jump. Now this was a really good chest for me. I've gotten quite a few chests like this, but this is probably about the best it gets right here. A couple times I've had three blue armors in one. You definitely need to make sure you're opening your chest if you get the chance to. Now, if you're trying to avoid PvP completely, there are some obvious red flags. You join a map and there's already mob bodies down. You might want to just leave if you're not looking for PvP, or if you just don't even want to risk it. It's better to just leave. Now, if you join a map and there are no bodies down, or even if there are, I recommend that you drop shock traps in doorways in order to secure your escape if you are attacked. I don't feel that hiding in grass is going to help any nakeds. whenever somebody comes in the map, they're checking that grass, and there's very limited bush for you to hide in, so it's more than likely going to get checked, but that's just my take on that. Now, I decided that this giant wasn't worth killing just from the bad luck I've been having with him. But I learned that even if you're not within aggro distance of the giant, as long as one of the other mobs are aggroed on you, the giant will also aggro on you. Like before, he will head back to his area after you're away a certain distance, but that's the only time he's gonna let you go. But he will aggro on you if other mobs are aggroed on you. You can see right here he starts moving on me even after I'm outside of his zone. It's like they communicate with each other. There's no way around it. I'm running very low on health. I'm running low on food. I'm running low on everything, and I've got these three mobs that have abilities on me. This is a very difficult fight. I'm just trying to buy as much time as I can, gain as much health as I can, and hopefully have a shot against these guys. I can't even risk fighting right there. One hit by that giant and I'll be dead. Abilities are back, it's time to make a move. And that's how it's done. I was still a little bit confused on why the giant had initially attacked me when the other mobs ran by. So I was sneaking in and out just to be safe, you know, because I was still questioning it. But after seeing the video, I came to the realization that it just, they're like bees, man. They just lock on. Now, normally you would take your orbs, that little statue to the left of the doorway there, and you would deposit them there in stacks of 10 or 20, depending on which map you're in. I don't know about you, but a few bolas, a few bandages, and some food is definitely worth all this blue gear to me. The gear I'm wearing and the gear I picked up in my inventory. If you do it like that and you just have a single weapon, cloth, and a couple supplies, you're able to get pretty far, in my opinion. Here's part of the loot that I got in my 3.5 hours of grinding. None of this was earned beforehand, so that's all profit. Now here's a short clip of how most of these guys who can eat nails for breakfast are gonna come into map. This guy he did the wrong thing. He honestly, with me being there, he could have just spun and I'd have let him off the hook. If people are submissive towards me or they're green, you know, I won't personally attack them. I won't attack nakeds. But if you're red and you're just hiding in a bush waiting there, you know, I'm gonna consider hitting you. And I knew that he had better than green armor on when I first logged in, so I was gonna just take care of him. If anybody's able to be in a position where they could possibly kill me off of like a bad PvP move or something, I will take them out, which is expected, honestly. So he does have some decent gear. You know, there's plenty of good stuff for us to use in the future or to donate. And hey, there's our bandages and potions. What mainly made me decide to kill him was, for one, his level of gear, and for two, there's already someone else's bag in the map. I'm actually heading down right now to check who that person is, but just that alone, that tells me that he killed somebody. Odds are he was the one to kill that person. I'm not gonna take him as not a threat if I see somebody else's bag there already. Now, a naked just rolled up on me. Obviously, I'm not gonna attack him. That's just not how I do. He's just trying to get something. I spin right here because I'm wanting to give him some gear. I was just gonna give him that guy's gear that I killed, but he apparently didn't get the memo. Me spinning for him. I even went green for him just so if he goes green, you know, and that other guy comes in, that we're not killing each other, since I don't really want to kill him. And honestly, I don't want him to kill me by accident either. A bull on the wrong person or something like that could really just ruin my whole dynamic right now of being in control. So that's the video. I hope I was able to help you guys out in some way. Thank you for watching. Caught up in my feelings, I
Fuck around and kill another nigga, you ain't even gotta push me how I'm feeling now. I've been having mood swings like a Gemini. I could use the murder for therapy. I can make the news with it. Break the internet, have them all nervous and scared of me. Then get away sneaky clean, never seen a thing. I got